Cohort Comparison Tool Genomic Data Commons, GDC 2.0 Video Guides, Charlotte Sackett, GDC User Services Scientific Support Analyst, Center for Translational Data Science, University of Chicago. Introduction to the Cohort Comparison Tool. The GDC's Cohort Comparison Tool generates a series of graphs and tables that compare and contrast two cohorts. In this video, we will use the Cohort Comparison Tool to create survival plots, Venn diagrams, and bar plots that visualize the similarities and differences between the active cohort and a different saved cohort. How to access the Cohort Comparison Tool. To access the Cohort Comparison Tool, we will first load the GDC's Data Portal homepage at portal.gdc.cancer.gov, then click on Analysis Center, which is the computer screen icon in the upper left corner of the webpage. Under the Analysis Tools section, we will locate the Cohort Comparison card, which is third from the left in this tutorial. Please note that the locations of the tool cards may change, so it is important to read the title of the cards. Once we have located the Cohort Comparison card, we will click on the Play button in the upper right corner of the tile. How to use the Cohort Comparison Tool. When the Cohort Comparison Tool is launched, we will see the active cohort in the Cohort toolbar. Note that before we can run the Cohort Comparison Tool, we must have two cohorts already created. If you do not have two cohorts, please pause this video and use the Cohort Builder tool to create them. You can refer to the GDC Cohort Builder video for assistance. The current active cohort consists of 50-plus-year-old lung cancer cases with RNA-seq data, as shown in the Cohort toolbar. In the Cohort Comparison Selection section below, we see a list of previously saved cohorts, including a cohort of under 50 lung cancer cases with RNA-seq data. Since there is only one non-active cohort, we will select the cohort of under 50 lung cancer cases with RNA-seq data. If you have other saved cohorts, you can choose any of them to compare with your active cohort by clicking the corresponding bubble in the Select column. Once we've selected the cohort which we want to compare with the active cohort, we will click the teal Run button in the bottom right corner. When the Cohort Comparison Tool is run, several visualizations are automatically populated with data from the two cohorts. A plot for overall survival appears on the left side of the screen, displaying Cohort 1, S1 in blue, and Cohort 2, S2 in orange. The plot presents duration in years along the x-axis and survival rate along the y-axis, as well as the log rank test p-value below the title. To zoom into the survival plot, we click and hold and drag the crosshair to select the area to zoom into. We can reset the view by clicking on the blue cyclical arrow reset button in the upper right corner of the plot. We can also view specific case data by hovering the mouse over the survival curve to display case ID, survival rate, and time of death or interval of last follow-up. Below the survival plot, we see a table with the number and percent of cases that were included in the survival analysis for each cohort. We can see that 97% and 95% of 50-plus and under 50 lung cancer cases with RNA-seq data, respectively, were included in the analysis. For a case to be included in the analysis, it must meet two criteria. One, the case is only in one of the cohorts, not both, and two, the case has the required data for the analysis. Since there are no cases in both cohorts, we can deduce that the 44 cases that were excluded from the survival analysis do not have the required data. To the right of the survival plot is a key displaying the two cohorts and number of cases in each, along with the color coding used in the visualizations on this page. The individual plots in the Cohort Comparison tool do not have legends, but this key can always be found in the upper right corner of the page. Below the key is a Venn diagram which presents the number of cases in Cohort 1 in the circle on the left, the number of cases in Cohort 2 in the circle on the right, and, if any, the number of cases in both cohorts in the overlapping section. In this example, there are 1,223 cases in cohort 1, 125 cases in cohort 2, and no cases that appear in both. This is expected since our two cohorts are exclusive of one another based on the under 50 and 50 plus age filters. Clicking on the Open Venn Diagram link will launch the Set Operations tool, which will be discussed in the GDC Set Operations tool video. Scrolling down the page, bar plots and tables for certain clinical facets are displayed below the survival plot, including gender, vital status, and age at diagnosis. Each bar plot compares the percent of cases between the two cohorts for each category. For example, the gender bar plot shows that there is a slightly higher percentage of males among lung cancer cases with RNA-seq data aged 50 plus in blue, compared to those less than 50 years old in orange. Conversely, there is a slightly higher percentage of females among lung cancer cases with RNA-seq data under 50 in orange than 50 and over in blue. We can also hover over each bar to display the cohort as well as the number and percent of cases in each category. Below the visual is a table presenting the same information, that is, number and percent of cases for each cohort and each category. A p-value also appears to the bottom right of each clinical facets table. Underneath the Venn diagram is a list of available clinical facets. As mentioned, the visuals for survival, gender, vital status, and age at diagnosis are already displayed, as indicated by the check marks in their corresponding boxes. The graph for age at diagnosis is interesting because it shows the distribution of age for each of our cohorts. But if we're more interested in comparing between our two cohorts rather than within each cohort, we can remove this clinical facet by unchecking its associated box. We can also add a clinical facet by checking its box. Let's bring back the graph for age at diagnosis. Saving the data visualizations. The survival plot and the raw data used to generate it, as well as the data tables, can be downloaded directly from the cohort comparison tool. To download the survival plot and its raw data, we can click on the download icon in the upper right corner of the plot, then select the format, either SVG or PNG for the image, and JSON or TSV for the data. Additionally, the bar plots data tables can be downloaded in TSV format by clicking on the buttons labeled TSV directly above and to the right of the tables. Creating cohorts from the cohort comparison tool. Another feature of the cohort comparison tool is that we can create new unsaved cohorts directly from the tool. Within the data tables are two columns, one for the number of cases in cohort 1, S1, and another for the number of cases in cohort 2, S2. These two columns contain buttons that can be used to create new cohorts based on the clinical facets category. For example, the data table for gender contains four buttons total since there are two categories, male and female, and two cohorts, S1 and S2. If there are no cases in a specific category for a given cohort, then the button will be grayed out and a new cohort cannot be created with those parameters since it would be empty. To create a new cohort of male lung cancer cases aged 50 plus with RNA-seq data, we will click on the button corresponding to the column Number Cases S1 and the row Male. Clicking on one of the buttons in the Number Cases columns, labeled plus 768 in this example, opens a pop-up window where we can save and name the new cohort Male Lung 50 plus RNA. Once we click the teal Save button in the bottom right corner, the cohort will save as indicated by a message at the top of the screen, and the cohort comparison tool page will return. Exiting the cohort comparison tool. To exit, we can click the X button to the left side of the cohort comparison header, which will bring us back to the analysis center. For more guidance on this and other GDC data portal tools, please refer to the video tutorials or go to docs.gdc.cancer.gov.